In this packet, we'll start by looking at arc length of a curve. We want to find the length, L, of the curve. Recall the distance formula. Let's draw some points on the curve to get a better idea how to figure this out. Ultimately, we want infinitely many points on the graph, so we could use the distance formula to sum up all their distances. Now that we set the graph up, we can write an expression that represents the sum of the segments. Again, we use the distance formula to express the distance of a segment. Remember, this is just changing x. And this is just changing y. We rewrite this using delta x and delta y notation. Note that we have to put delta y sub I here. This is because even though change in x is always the same, the change in y may not be. Now we apply the mean value theorem as we see here. Now we plug this into our segment formula, so we will have everything in terms of x. Let's simplify this a bit to get it in a form we can use. And now, let's take the limit as n goes to infinity of the Riemann sum to get the exact value of the arc length. And of course, we express this as an integral, and now we have a general formula for arc length of a curve. Note, we can also express the integral in terms of y if necessary. Now, let's do an example. Now that we've derived the arc length formula, we just need to find y prime and plug it in our integral. do a quick u substitution. And integrate. And done. Another example. Notice this is in terms of y, so let's keep it that way. So we find x prime, or g prime of y, and plug it into our integral, then evaluate.
Phew.
A lot of simplifying before we get to the integration. Finally, a nice form so we can easily integrate. And our arc length of the curve from 1 to 2 is 33/16 or 2 1/16. The next couple of examples we will do in class. Now we know we can find arc length of any curve from A to B, we may want to find a general arc length function. And we can, using the first part of the fundamental theorem of calculus, as kind of described here. An example. And here is our arc length function for whatever x we want starting at x equals 1.